The Lord your God has directed all of your journeying in the desert.
Not a participation in the blood of Christ.
But just think how more we can become if we allow the Lord regularly to keep changing us. This is so big. Amazing. I thought it might be kind of fun to share with you a little sketch of my connections with your faith community, already beginning when Father Harold Ide was pastor here and Father Ed Eschweiler was here. How many of you remember Father Ide and Father Ed Eschweiler? Quite a few. Well, at that time, I was newly ordained, and there's a group of priests that would gather to reflect on the scriptures occasionally to prepare for our homilies, and then also to enjoy dinner together. And a couple of times, Father Harold and Father Ed hosted our group here at the St. James Rectory. So that was my initial encounter with the St. James faith community here. And then through the years, I was assigned for a while at St. Mary in Sheboygan Falls. And we were looking for the first full-time liturgist musician. The parish never had one before. And we found a person actually advertising himself in the Milwaukee Journal, said, highly qualified church musician looking to relocate in Sheboygan County. And we'd hired then a person who became a very good friend, Stephen Nafeen, as our first liturgist musician. And it so happened that Stephen had gone to college with Barb Schilke. And so through the years, Steve and Barb and I would go to different pastoral musician conventions just to kind of keep up with church music and liturgy. And through that, then I became acquainted with Barb and further learned more about St. James. And because of that contact, Father Gene, when you were ready to dedicate this beautiful worship space, he invited me here for the dedication of the church. So I was here in 1999. And I remember after the dedication, talking to Father Gene a little bit, I was just so taken with the beauty and the wonderful space and the lively worship and the great spirit of the community. And I said to Father Gene, you know, someday I'd like to be here. Well, your parish was available 6 years ago. I applied. Father Art had seniority on me. And it's fascinating, I heard 6 years ago, this was the most applied for parish of all of the parishes that had openings at the time. So I didn't receive the appointment then, and so I ended up going to St. Mary in West Bend for 6 years. Prior to that, I did 5 years in Waupun at St. Joseph Parish in Waupun. But as things happen, now you've been able to have a wonderful 6 years with Father Art. Father Art was one of my favorite professors in the seminary. Very dynamic and very inspiring and passionate and wonderful ministry skills. And he's one of my favorites. And so now you've had the joy and the blessing of his ministry for these past 6 years. And now he has kind of driven off into the sunset. And now, my long hoped for assignment has finally arrived, and I am extremely grateful that I have been entrusted with this parish and entrusted to become a part of your faith community. I remember when Father Art first heard that I was interested, he said, oh, he's too young for a big parish. Well, I think he still saw me as his student, because in 9 years, I can retire. So I'm not too young. But I'm thrilled to be a part of your faith community for many years to come. And I'm thrilled that we have this opportunity to begin our faith relationship as we celebrate what we call traditionally Corpus Christi, the body and the blood of Christ. Because really, that's what we are all about, being the living body and blood of Christ, bringing Christ to all our relationships, our places of business, our recreation, all the spheres of day-to-day life. And we're able to do that because we come here each week to be further transformed into that living body and blood of Christ. We become what we eat. And isn't that tremendous good news? Who could ever even hope to come close to embodying those values of Jesus, of reconciliation, of compassion, of forgiveness, of sensitivity to the poor and the needy? All those wonderful things we see demonstrated so well in Jesus, we couldn't hope to achieve, but we can be transformed by the Lord himself. The Eastern Church has a wonderful way of talking about it. They speak of our call to become divinized, to become divine, to become transformed into the very presence of God. And a prayer that maybe you don't often hear is kind of sometimes a quiet prayer when we prepare the bread and the wine. We pour a little bit of the water into the wine. We say something like, by the mingling of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share our humanity. We are divinized. We are transformed. We become the living body and blood of Christ. And that's why it's so valuable that we gather week after week at the Lord's table to encourage one another, to be Christ for one another, and to let that Spirit of Jesus further transform us into his living presence. I'm the oldest of five boys. And one time I was at the doctor's office, and the doctor was just making a little chit-chat as he's going through the records, and he asked about my family, and I said, yes, I have four brothers younger than myself. And he says, oh, are any of them like you? And I said, oh, no, they're just the opposite. And he stopped, and he looked shocked, and he said, are they evil? I said, no, what I mean is I'm in church all the time, and they're not. Well, I shared that story with my brother Tim. He was offended. He looked kind of like a whipped puppy, and he said, but I'm a good person. Well, of course he's a good person, but just think how more we can become if we allow the Lord regularly to keep changing us. And it's tough many times to live those values of Jesus. And we need to come here to be reminded we're not expected to do it all by ourselves. The Lord wants to be our life-giving bread. The Lord intends to satisfy our deepest thirsts. But we need to present ourselves. We need to open ourselves so he can do his work, so he can further empower us with his Spirit and the gifts of the Spirit that we celebrated just a couple of weeks ago. So it's a wonderful way to kind of launch into the summertime, the time of ordinary time in our church calendar, when there aren't any specific feasts or celebrations going on, to allow the Lord to continue to be our life-giving bread, to continue transforming us, so we in turn become life-giving bread for others. You and I can be that bread for our world, a world that hungers for the Spirit, a world that hungers for the very life of the risen Lord, and thirsts for those refreshing waters that we have been commissioned to bring by our baptism. And so I'm very grateful to begin my time with all of you this weekend as we celebrate Corpus Christi, the body and the blood of Christ, and to come together to be further fashioned into a people that our God makes his own.